California libraries benefit greatly from all kinds of skilled volunteers all around the state. And today we've taken some time to interview some volunteers and their staff members to see what's made them successful and what ideas they can share to help you. So I hope you enjoy watching the stories that we filmed for you today and that you take something away that'll be beneficial to you and your library. I was looking for somebody who could help me up my game in the social media realm because I do a Twitter feed and a Facebook page for our library literacy program to recruit volunteers and raise awareness. And so I was looking for somebody with high skills, and I designed a job description, posted it on Volunteer Match, and I linked it to a skill so that it also shares that opportunity on LinkedIn. Tell the folks a little bit about what your background, your skills are, and then how did you find this position?
I believe I found it on Volunteer Match, although I'm also on LinkedIn.
Yeah.
I had used Volunteer Match back in San Francisco, and I would do kind of periodic volunteer or short volunteer gigs with them. And so I knew when I moved here and I wanted to find a volunteer role, I knew that that was the perfect place to look, and just happened to stumble upon this one, which stood out because it said social media and given my background. Also because I had a new job, I was a little bit concerned about, you know, my time and what I could allocate. Mm-hmm. So I knew because it was social media that maybe it would be, that I would be able to do some work from home.
When we started growing our volunteer program at the State Library, it quickly became clear that I didn't have enough time to do everything that needed to be done. And I thought, you know, if I could find somebody who would be willing to help us work on this with us and take some pieces off my plate, we could go a lot farther. So I actually created a job description called Assistant Volunteer Coordinator, and I posted it on Volunteer Match, and I did some interviews, and we selected you hands down. But do you want to talk about what's your past experiences and how did you find this position?
I went on Volunteer Match and I found this place I'd never heard of before, the State Library, and I love libraries. Mm-hmm. So I was very excited to learn about it, and I just felt that my administration skills fit with what you were looking for. I was looking for something to get me out of the house a little bit more, but I will not give this position up as long as it's there for me.
When it became time for us to have a 30th anniversary celebration for our statewide literacy program, I realized that I didn't have the expertise and didn't have the resources available to me to try to come up with a statewide public relations campaign that would help us not only raise awareness about the adult literacy issue, but help us reach out to new volunteers who might join the program since we have a rather long waiting list statewide. So I decided, well, like I always do, if I don't have the resources available, would there be a way for me to find a volunteer who could help with it? So I wrote a job description for literacy public relations specialist and posted it on LinkedIn, and I found this awesome guy, Dan Dement, who worked with us for, at least 6 months, maybe longer, right?
A little bit longer, yeah.
So Dan, just talk a little bit about your background, your expertise, and what drew you to this position.
I was in the process of actually starting my own public relations consultancy. Mm-hmm. And in the process of building that and networking, you know, there's a good old adage that volunteering is good career karma. Mm-hmm. And it's a great networking opportunity. So it became one of the staples that I wanted to make sure I was doing. And I was looking at a couple different opportunities, and just perfect timing, I saw, like you mentioned, the post on LinkedIn. And I love the idea that it was with a part of the California State Library system. And as I read into the description about what it would be working with, and it would be the Library Literacy Services, as we've actually had really good personal conversations about, I was in the process of some challenges with my own son's reading. And I thought to myself, kind of, you know, I think you had some good literature already out at the time about what you do. And trying to put myself in the position of being a parent who maybe couldn't read to their child or help them with their reading homework period. And some of the stats that talk about the cycle of adult literacy, and that, you know, how much more apt a child who doesn't have a parent who can help them with their homework is more likely to be illiterate, you know, have low adult literacy themselves. It just immediately struck a chord with me, you know. And so, you know, that's kind of part of why I put such an effort into saying, and I said, you know what, I'm gonna go down there and meet him, and I really want to do this. So I put together the plan. I said, I would treat you just like I would treat any client. I want to make sure that we have good results when it's all said and done. And it's been it was a wonderful experience all the way through.
So Kathy, talk to us first about how did you all identify a need for job coaches and sort of briefly what it's like.
Well, it was a little bit unique in that the job coaching program started actually as a grant-funded program before I even started with the Sacramento Public Library. So by the time I came on board a few years ago, the grant money had gone away. And the conversation went to how do we keep this going? So I created a job position description, or a position description for a job coach, and posted it on Volunteer Match. That's how I recruited most of the job coaches that we have for the program throughout the system. But Scott was very unique in that he had been volunteering at the Rancho Cordova Library, and it was the staff at the Rancho Cordova Library that contacted me and said, we have the perfect candidate for a job coach, and he's very interested. So that's when Scott and I first met.
Great, great. And Scott, what attracted you to this volunteer job? What made you say yes when they asked you about it?
Well, I've been volunteering at the library for over a year and doing various things. I've always been a very outgoing and energetic person, looking for ways to contribute in whatever environment I was in. So the librarian, knew about my skills. I'm a retired teacher, so she said, are you interested in doing job coaching? I said, absolutely.
I guess I started by getting my master's degree in public administration, so I always assumed I would go into nonprofit or government management. Things didn't work out that way. That happens sometimes. And so I've been working in e-commerce marketing for the past 5 years. I started at a startup called Bureau of Trade, and it was a men's fashion e-commerce startup that eventually was acquired by eBay. And then from there, I moved on to Murano Group, which is a private equity firm. And they kind of buy up failing companies and turn them around. So I was doing some consulting there in primarily social media and email marketing. And then recently, I moved to Sacramento. And I started as a market manager at VSP Global, where I'm specializing in email marketing as well. But I'm no longer doing as much social media, which is why this was a perfect fit for me.
I was a law office administrator for 5 years. I've been volunteering since my early 20s, and I just don't like to stop volunteering. I like to give back.
With the literacy, it just struck a chord with me. Mm-hmm. I watching those videos that your video team put together, and I helped kind of pull together the messaging. I mean, I still watch them now again today, and it's still, I'm like, is anybody looking? Am I gonna choke up here? Because their stories are amazing. And like I said, putting myself in the position of wondering, okay, what if I couldn't help my own child? Mm-hmm. And think about how many, what we're looking at 4.5 as a low-end estimate of Californians who are below the literacy level they should be at to be able to help their kids do that. It just, I'm like, any way I could help. I may not have the time to volunteer after school because I've got my own kids, mm-hmm. and I coach their soccer and their baseball teams and help them with their homework, but what can I do? Mm-hmm. And what I could do was something during my regular business day, mm-hmm. something that to me comes easily. I love PR. I love, communications, business strategy communications for organizations. And so why not lend that?
When you came to Sacramento, you started a new job and didn't have the kind of control over your schedule that you do now. And so we started meeting on an online meeting platform called ReadyTalk. Even though you're just across town, we had never met because it worked so well to meet on ReadyTalk. Has that been weird for you, or have you found that useful?
Not at all. It was actually easier than I expected to start because I'd never used ReadyTalk before. But every time, we never seem to have a problem. I just dial in you know, log in on my computer, or we can see each other if we choose to, or if we were more shy, we may not share our cameras. But it works. It's been working out really well. And then we're able to also share documents just via email, so that I can get all the work I need to do done in my own time.
The law firm I worked at was workers' compensation. So when we first started, when I came in and they were developing the interviewing and what was needed, I just really felt there was a great need to make sure that there were timesheets, not just with hours, but with the exact times that people were there in case anybody did file a workers' compensation claim. And so that was a big change that I believe.
And that was a real insight for us. It was very helpful.
Yeah, that I believe I brought to the position, and I was glad that the head of HR was working with us at the beginning so I could really make that point that was needed. And then, of course, another big change has been Vlogistics.
Oh, right. Talk about that a little bit.
Because we didn't have year in.
Yeah, you and I had to learn that.
Yeah, and we found that there was a need for that. Mm-hmm. So once we brought on more volunteers, we needed to be able to keep track of them, to be sure that they were, you know, being kept track of, not just for the hours to make sure for workers' compensation, but also because we wanted to see how many volunteer hours were actually being given.
I mean, my, you know, professional background has spanned really, it's a combination of higher education and high technology, and then sometimes where those two intersect. And a lot of times it's very, very focused role at what I do. This gave me the great opportunity to kind of expand that and get creative. You know, we did the op-ed piece in the Sacramento Bee, which was great to talk about kicking off the campaign. Mm-hmm. And the more I thought about what you guys do, what the program was supposed to be about, what we were trying to accomplish with the 30th anniversary, it hit me. I don't know how better to explain it, but it's like, this is a real true together experience. Mm-hmm. You know, together, if we work together, California will read. Mm-hmm. You know, we changed the URL, we put the branding into the website design, we created some fantastic posters that, and I can't even take credit for this, you guys are the ones that, if I'm not mistaken, we put them on every door of the state legislature inside the Capitol building. And I was like, that's awesome. You know, like, who wouldn't want to be part of something like that? And so, you know, that I have you to thank.
Well, most of them ask for resume help. Some ask for help with searching for a job. And then there's a wide variety of things. Some people need to develop their math skills because they have to take a math test. So I have worksheets and math tests that I give them, and we take a look at their strengths. And as a retired math teacher, I really enjoy doing that. I had a client last week, and she wants to turn her house into a home to care for disabled people. And so she asked me for help with the application for the regional center. And as a regional center parent who has a disabled child, I was familiar with a lot of that stuff, so we sat down and did that. Some people need language help. I love the variety.
If they're concerned that they don't have enough time, just give it a shot. It's been incredible for me. I was a little bit concerned about not having enough time. Mm-hmm. And, you know, to be able to break up just a few hours a week here and there, anyone can do it. So I would say definitely give it a shot. And the whole staff is so supportive that I can't imagine it would be an issue.
And what people should know is we wouldn't have to do that just with somebody who lives in the same town. It's possible, but you could live in New York and we could do the same process. So it's in the business we call that being a virtual volunteer. And so until today, that's what you've been to me, a virtual volunteer, and it's been just great.
You know, I'm very interested in starting my own nonprofit, and having you as somebody to kind of bounce ideas off of once in a while has really been a benefit to me. Very so even true. Though the position is little hours, it's really very rewarding, and I talk it up quite a bit.
I also volunteer in other groups, with other groups in the community, and I encourage them to, you know, look at different opportunities. When we have people who come in that are fresh out of college, or they're very young, or they don't have a lot of things on their resume, I say, you know, a really wonderful thing to have on your resume is a volunteer time,
right.
You know, to show that you care about your community and you're a giving person.
you know, look at LinkedIn, look at Craigslist, look at some other online sources. There's a lot of good community organizations that need help. And I think you'll see something that'll be like, I can do that. And so if you have something that you do, you love as your career, look for a way to give back to the community. It could be locally, it could be state level, it could be regional, nationwide, global. I mean, just find something you can do, and the payoff's fantastic.
Awesome.
I mean, to teach somebody else how to read and know that they now can go and read a bedtime story to their child or their grandchild, doesn't warm the heart much better than that.
Yeah.